Alright folks, today we are making braised chicken thighs with garlic white wine sauce. Amazing, so stay tuned. It's time to grill! Let's get started with 6 chicken thighs. And we are seasoning the chicken pieces with Magic Green. Of course you can use your favorite barbecue rub here. Magic Green is kind of a magic dust, only with green ingredients, so green paprika and so on. It's a cooperational thing between me and German's spice dealer Spice Bar. You might have seen it in the past, but feel free to use your favorite barbecue rub, as I said. Now let's go for the grill. We are needing a charcoal grill for today. Doesn't exactly matter which one. We already have started a starting chimney half full of charcoal briquettes. And now we have a great direct heat and we are putting our Dutch oven or camp oven directly onto the coals. We have now a real high direct heat. We are adding sunflower oil and we are grilling the chicken pieces 3 minutes per side with the maximum heat possible. It doesn't matter if they get a little bit darker at this part of the recipe. We want to create flavor. And we already have enough flavor in the cast iron pan after you have taken them out again. I started with the first 3. You remember we had 6. So now keep going with the other 3 chicken pieces. If you want to recreate this dish at home, make sure to check the video description. We have the whole list of ingredients and measurements in there. After you have taken out all those chicken thighs, add leek. You will need some veggies now. For this video I decided not to show you the cutting work. You will need a lot of garlic, onions as well. And some more veggies. Such there is. Diced carrot, parsnips and celery. This all makes a good sauce and a good flavor, I promise. Keep going with the high heat 4 or 5 minutes, then take tomato paste. Let the tomato paste sit on the cast iron with a high heat as well for 2 or 3 minutes. It will get a great flavor. Roasted tomato paste is really, really awesome. Now give it a good mix. You can now see it starts to look a little bit like tomato color. Add some balsamic vinegar. I like that. The acid is really important in dishes like that. And I love to add the balsamic vinegar into the hot cast iron. Now give it a good mix. And now place your chicken pieces back into the pan. We start with the first 3. By the way, the weather in Germany still sucks, so this is the dishes we are going for this season. Add half a bottle of white wine. I added more and more white wine later while cooking. Tomato sauce, bay leaves, and the other 3 chicken pieces that are still outside. The rest is rather easy. You add the lid. Put some coals on top and let that cook for a total cooking time of 3 hours and 30 minutes. That should be enough. If your charcoal is a high quality charcoal, they might last long enough for that cooking time. Every half an hour till 45 minutes, I open the lid and see how it's cooking. In the beginning, it's still cooking. At the end, it's more or less a little bit simmering. Now the veggies will start to soak up a little bit of the white wine and the liquid and the sauce. That's why you have to keep in mind to add more white wine if you have the feeling you have less liquid and less sauce inside the oven. All in all, I put in a complete bottle of white wine. I'm using Sauvignon Blanc and this is the white wine I'm also drinking. I'm a fan of the idea of using to cook what you're drinking. And here is the result. We have nice, juicy and tender chicken thighs. We have a rich sauce. By the way, I skipped that salt and pepper inside the video. You have to add some salt and pepper at the end. And here is, the colors are amazing. And you can now take out the bone from the chicken easy. And braised chicken with white wine garlic sauce is really, really amazing. Can't wait to hear what you think about that dish. Make sure to hit that like button and subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. I'm gonna eat this right now. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm out. See you.